Someone save me. Hey guys, and welcome back to my channel, and welcome to today's video. So today we're going to be setting up our sinking funds for May to save a little bit of time because this is going to be kind of a combined video. It's going to be a really weird video, but because of scheduling and stuff like that, it just had to happen. So again, sorry for the weird format of this video, but to save some time, like I said, I did already set up the pages using my stickers, and I drew out all the lines, put in my categories. We'll talk more about that in a second, but I wanted to start by talking about the new Daily Duo. So if you guys are not new to the Erin Condren world, then you know that every May there are new planners that come out. So today I'm going to be showing you guys the Erin Condren Daily Duo Planner. This is the daily planner that they have split into two separate planners. So here's the first one. This is the one that starts in July. And then there is another one as well. So they sent this along with a bunch of accessories. So thank you, Erin Condren and the team, for sending them my way. I've been using Erin Condren products for, I wanna say, 4 years now. And I just love the quality. Honestly, that's what has me coming back, is I love the quality of the planners. So anyway, today I'm gonna show you guys a little bit of the planner. There's not a ton of changes when it comes to the planner. There are a few different sizes now, but like I said, this is the 7x9. This is the one I'm planning on using. So I got the rose gold coil, and then I don't know if I put in my name wrong or if that was an accident, but they are sending a new cover. So that's always nice. So with the 7x9 Daily Duo, the only option for like the style of it is the mid-century circles. I know some people have mixed feelings about it. I've seen comments and stuff on Facebook groups. I personally like the mid-century circles. It's not something that I don't like. So anyway, with the Daily Duo, I feel like less is more because I want to make the Daily Duo and honestly any planner, I want to make it my own. So the less stuff they have going on, the more I can personalize it myself using my sticker. So anyway, you get the little vellum page there, a place where you can put your name. Then you also get the 6 boxes over here. People use this for a number of things. I found over the years that I really don't end up using any of the extra pages. I don't do a ton of like crazy extra planning. I normally just stick to my monthly view and just put items in there. So that's kind of what I'm gonna do. When I get Macy's school schedule, I'll put in her school dates into both planners. I'll also put any like family dates or anything going on in the monthly view as well. That is one difference, is in the past, I believe we used to get like a little, actually, mine is right here. The one I'm currently using is right here. So I think in the past we got, we got like these boxes here so that you can kind of mark certain things. We don't have that this time, which some people may not like. They may like having this, but if you remember, you'd have the 6 months here where you could put items down, and then it jumped to 2022, which was interesting because this ends in June. So I'm glad that it's not goofy anymore, but I can see people getting upset that there's no longer like this overview. Again, I don't use it personally, but it was something that I know a lot of people used. So anyway, you get these 6 boxes. I like it because you could really make it your own. If you want to track dates, you can do that. You could honestly split these into half boxes and make it work. Then going into the monthly view, one thing that I can say is with the designs that I have seen, it seems like it's getting harder and harder to cover up. So for example, the mid-century circles is up all the way to the top now, and that is going to make it way more difficult for shop owners to make stickers that cover that, because I mean, there's just no way to cover everything. I mean, the pattern goes all the way to like the coil part. So just kind of keep that in mind. I don't think it's gonna bother me too much. I will kind of make it work, but I just figured I'd mention it. The other thing is there used to be like a strip of color down here. That's no longer the case either. I'll show you June. So like before, it was a little bit more like in a box and easier to cover. You had that color down there. I personally prefer more of this style. just so that, again, most people, I feel like, use stickers in their planners to cover up stuff, and it's a lot easier to do that here, but we'll make it work. But yeah, there's not really a ton to say about that. One major change that I have noticed with the planners is that now, instead of having the weekend on a combined page, now you have two separate pages. So that's something that's really going to be nice, just to have like a schedule for both days. I know lots of people, you know, make their weekends the way that they want it. I personally use like the top part as my checklist. And again, let me just show you. I feel like it makes most sense to show you. So for example, this is kind of the way that I set up mine. I have check boxes and then I'll put events, but I am looking forward to having more space and getting to like time block things. And again, just have a better layout there. Now, that does mean that you're gonna have more pages. And let me tell you guys, I mean, my planner is a media sample. So some things that you see in my planner may not be the same for the planner that you end up getting. I'll talk about that in a second, but this planner is very thick already. So just kind of keep that in mind. Again, I think right now I have a 12-month coil on here. I don't know if they're gonna use bigger coils, but this is already very, very maxed. So just figured I'd mention that. I don't think it's gonna be a problem. I don't use a ton of stickers. You guys have seen, like, I'll use the date covers because I love doing that. And then I have like stickers and stuff spread out throughout the day. I never feel like my planner gets super bulky, but that's something that you should keep in mind when it comes to the planners. Again, it may be completely different with the actual planners, not the media sample, but I figured I'd mention that. And then you may have seen this extra white page. This is part of the media samples. This is not going to be part of the actual planners that are released to everybody else. It is kind of a bummer though, because I kind of like that. That may take some bulkiness out, but it is in between each week, and I feel like this would be a good place where you could put together like a to-do list and a to-call list, kind of like a sidebar. So anyway, again, I don't think this is going to be part of the daily duo according to the emails that I've received, but I figured I'd mention that. And then in the very back you get some stickers. These are pretty much the same, and then you get a little folder here in the back and one of these perpetual calendars where you can put in birthdays or whatever else you may need. So yeah, I am super excited about it. I'm definitely looking forward to seeing the other sizes and seeing all of the different versions of the kit, or not the kits, the planners. So if you are not already a part of my Facebook group and you purchased my stickers, definitely go join. I do have a poll going on right now as we speak that is basically what I'm going to use to decide if I'm going to add more options for different planners into my shop. So I know like a lot of people are interested in the A5 Daily Duo. So if you are wanting to, you know, pick up stickers for my shop and you're wanting different sizes, definitely go vote there. That's probably the best area to do it. But yeah, I am super excited about these new ones. I'm excited to finally have it in my hands and start like putting things into my planner, because I have some stuff coming up in July that I need to mark. But yeah, that is my little overview. Again, there's accessories and stuff like that. I'm not going to show that here because I'm a little pressed on time. I'm gonna have to pick Macy up very soon, but I just wanted to show you guys that really quick. And then let's go ahead and get into today's sinking fund video. So I haven't closed my sinking funds yet for the month of April. We still have some things coming and going out of there, so I didn't want to close it just yet, but we are getting close to the end of April, so I will at some point. And if you don't already check out my weekly check-ins, I definitely recommend checking those out. I go into my sinking funds there and I talk more about, like, you know, what's coming in, what's coming out. You guys can see my beginning balances and all of that fun stuff. So again, because I already put the stickers down, I can just add the amounts and talk through each item. So for beauty, I'm going to be putting in $50. This is, a lot of these amounts are the same every single month unless, you know, something changes, which there are a few changes this month, so you'll see that. So Beauty is $50. Beauty is really for my foundation. I really don't wear a ton of makeup, but I do wear Clinique. I think it's called Almost Powder Makeup Foundation. And then I use the Acne Solutions Clinique face wash and stuff. That has been stuff that I've been using, I think, since like high school, and it just works really well with my face. So I put a little money aside so that when those come due and I need to pick those up again, I have the money set aside, and it's not something that's just like, oh, bam, $100 for something. Next is car insurance. We put in $150 for car insurance every single month. Next is car maintenance. So we put in $50 for car maintenance. Jason and I both have, like, I don't know, maybe it's not fairly new, but I feel like it's fairly new cars. I have a 2013 Prius and Jason has a 2018 RAV4. So we're not doing a ton of maintenance for either of those cars, but as the cars get older, you're gonna have more repairs and stuff like that. So it's just nice, even though we're not spending a lot of money right now on those things, it's nice to have the money set aside for when things do happen. Because if there's anything that you can depend on, it's that when you don't have money saved for car repairs, that's when you're going to have car repairs. That's just how it happens. Next is car tags. So in Illinois, we have to pay for like a little sticker that goes on our car. And we put away $35 for that every month because it's, I think, $130 or $150 per car now. So it's getting up there. Next is chatbooks. This is what we use for the girls' pictures. So again, we just put $10 away every month. And then when we get the chatbooks, I think they're around $10 each. We have a whole series for Macy, a whole series for Mila. And I seriously love them for like photos, like for photo storage. It's the perfect setup. Next is Christmas and gifts. So we combine these two because honestly, I feel like that just makes it easier to just have a set amount in there. We put $250 away every month for that, and that has been working great, so we're gonna stick with that. Next is going to be clothes. So we each get $50 per month for clothes. So Jason gets 50, the girls get 100 into their sinking fund, and I get $50 as well. So Jason actually hasn't used his sinking fund for clothes yet. I know he has to pick up some new jeans because all of his jeans seem to like just all rip in the same place recently. So he's gonna be using some money, I think, sometime in May. The girls, I just picked up clothes for them, like summer clothes for them. And I think we still have plenty of money in there for them, which is great. I do combine their clothes because for the most part, Mila is wearing Macy's hand-me-downs. We have a lot of clothes like from 18 months until now. We got rid of a lot of baby clothes. We had to repurchase all of those. But when Macy was around too, that was around the time that we were thinking that we may have another baby. And so we held on to some stuff. So now it's really just like little things for Mila. But of course, Macy has to have new clothes. So $100 per month has been very good, and honestly, we have plenty of money in there. So if we ever need to purchase something like extra, like a fancy dress for something, or if, I don't know, just bigger things, we have money set aside for that. Next is Costco. So we do have a Costco membership, and we put $5 away for that so that when the $60 bill, annual bill comes due, we have it. Again, not a ton of money, but it's just nice having it so that we don't have to, you know, have a $60 extra item. Next is diapers, and diapers is like extremely funded right now, so I'm gonna put nothing in there. We've been doing $100, and honestly, I think like with as kids get older, they start using less diapers. So anyway, I think we have plenty of money in there. We're going to put nothing in right now and just kind of ride out the money that's in there. Next is entertainment. We're gonna do $100 for entertainment. As the summer gets closer, we'll probably go to pools and just like walk up for ice cream and stuff like that. So it's just nice having some money set aside to do fun things like that. And then if we don't use it, it just builds up. So when we do have time to do some fun stuff, we'll have it there. For family pictures, we put in $25 per month, and this is for a few things. It's mostly for like our annual family pictures that we get done in the fall. It's also for Macy's school pictures. We do like to purchase those every year. It also can include if we like print pictures, because we do have like a little photo wall in our living room, so I need to do that still. I took all the pictures down when we were listing our house and I haven't put them back up, so I'm gonna be using some of that money soon. Next is going to be golf. So Jason loves golfing. He's actually pretty good at it too. So we put $25 away for that so that when he wants to go golfing, he has the money there. Honestly, the golf sinking fund does not cover all of his golfing expenses. He uses his allowance for some of it too, but this is just money set aside, like a small amount, so that it's not like he's using all of his allowance for golf, if that makes sense. And I think he uses this mostly when he's gonna like go and do a nicer course, or if he's gonna just go to the driving range. So anyway, that's what's there. Something that's new this month. I shouldn't be allowed to film after like a long day of cutting and everything because I feel like my brain is just tired. So anyway, I'm doing one little calculation because I want to make sure that this is correct. Yes. Okay, so next is home maintenance, and we have been on a roller coaster of house stuff. You guys have probably heard so much about it that you don't want to hear anything else, but we've decided to stay at our house until the market gets better and it's not so crazy and competitive. So for the time being, we're going to start putting like an actual amount into home maintenance that is somewhat resembling what you would do if you were planning on staying in your house. Our house is older. I think it was made in the 60s. So there's just little things over time that will need to be replaced, and we don't know when we're going to be moving. So I just want to have money set aside for when an appliance breaks or when we have a plumbing issue or whatever it may be. So when we were going to sell our house, we bought our house for like just over $250 when we originally bought it. Now it's worth closer to $300. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to do 1% of our home value per year divided by, obviously, by 12 months. So that's going to bring us to $250 per month. So that's what we're going to do going forward. Again, it's not going to cover everything. If you have a big problem at your house, you know, a couple thousand dollars is not going to make a big difference, but it's just something. And of course, we still have our emergency fund. We still have extra savings as well. So this is more just for, you know, having money set aside for when something happens. Next is medical. So this is for like any medical or dental expenses that we may have. So we put $50 away for that. Next is tolls, so we put $10 away for that every month. And then for trash, I'm gonna put in nothing because we have quite a bit of money in there already. Vacation is next, we're gonna put $250 away for that. And then water is $50. So you may see that we have some utilities in here. So for trash and water, those are bills that are not every month. Trash is every 3 months, water is every 2 months. And so instead of having like every couple months having a water bill or every couple months having a trash bill, I just decided to split it evenly over every month. That way we don't have any ups and downs in our budget. I try and make our budget as smooth as possible. So that's why we have some utilities in here. But that brings us to a total of $1,510 for the month. That's what we're going to be adding to our sinking funds for the month. So that's all set up and ready to go. I get a lot of questions about how we handle our sinking funds, and so I figured I'd really quickly just mention here. So at the end of the month, I will net all of our sinking funds. I'll figure out what our ending balance is. Our ending balance is what will go into the beginning balance of the new month. And I'll take that beginning balance plus what we're adding, and that's what I know needs to be in our sinking fund account. I use our credit card for everything because we pay off our credit card completely at the end of the month. And so to get the bonus points or whatever it may be, we use our card for everything. I also kind of like that, like, all of our bills and expenses and stuff I can see in one place. So anyway, I use our credit card for everything, including sinking funds, and then I kind of net it out. So I'll take the beginning plus the what we're adding, and I know that's what the balance should be. So sometimes, some months, I have to add money to our sinking fund account. Sometimes I need to take some money away. For the most part, I would say, like, I'm adding to it, but there's definitely times where, like, if we have a lot of expenses come out of sinking funds, then I can take a little money away. So it's a lot of, like, back and forth. I honestly don't mind it. This is like a whole separate checking account. So like this balance plus the beginning is in a completely separate checking account from our normal checking account. And I like that because the money that I see in our normal checking account, I feel like that's like our money. Like it's just for like whatever may need, whatever happens. With our sinking fund checking account, I honestly feel like this money's already spent. Even though obviously we still have it sitting there for when we need to spend it, I honestly, in my mind, think of it as being spent. So when I need to purchase things, when I need to buy my makeup, or when we need to buy clothes for the girls, I don't have to feel bad about it. I don't have to like second guess it, because in my mind, the money was already spent. The second that I moved the money from our normal checking account to our sinking fund account. Now, I don't go crazy. I purposely split all of the money into separate categories because for me, I feel like that gives me a game plan for what the money is meant for. But again, I feel like doing it this way makes me not second guess having to purchase the things that I'm gonna have to purchase. Like, I don't ever feel bad about picking up diapers because of course I have to pick up diapers. But like when you're spending $100 on diapers and it's coming out of your normal account and you're trying to like build that account up, it sometimes just feels, you know, I don't know. I don't know if that makes any sense. Let me know if you guys feel the same way about the sinking funds. In my mind, again, I just kind of write it off. As soon as we transfer the money, it's almost like gone in my mind. So I never think twice about spending the money that's in this account. Of course, I don't go crazy, but I feel like it also gives me like the permission to spend it because I'm making a plan. I have an idea of why I'm putting the money aside, what it's for. So anyway, those are our sinking funds for May. At some point when I close out our April budget, I will add in the beginning balance. I'll start tracking whatever transactions that we have from the sinking funds here. But yeah, that is today's video. I hope you guys enjoyed seeing the little daily duo, the new daily duo, hearing what's going on with our sinking funds. Let me know if you guys are picking up a new Erin Condren planner. Let me know which one you're picking up and make sure that you go and vote if you are planning to pick up stickers from my shop so I know which sizes and planners and all of that that you guys are looking for. So anyway, thank you guys again and I'll see you next time. Bye guys.
Don't need someone to save me.